sit at these original walnut desks, and a lot of furniture here in the Capitol is original. It came to us from Chicago, Illinois. Furniture company that sent all of this in about 1890, so we like to maintain it pretty well, make sure we can keep using it. It is about 131 years old, and we want it to last for another 131 years, so monitor it pretty well. Now, they vote using a pretty traditional method. They call out their votes with their voices, or they can raise a hand and hold up one finger for yes, two for no, or three for present but not voting. And they're presided over by the Lieutenant Governor. Something we do in Texas that is a little bit different from other states, our governor and Lieutenant Governor are elected on separate tickets, so they can be of different political parties. Right now, our governor is very active. They are both Republicans, but it has happened in the past where we've had one who's a Democrat and one who's a Republican. Now, they are in session here in Texas through the end of May, for the odd number of years only, so part-time legislature. And when they are in session, you can actually come in here and see what's going on, how they make Texas laws. So upstairs, you'll see the public gallery designed for transparency of government. They want you to be able to come in here and see what they're talking about. So you don't need a ticket for this. You don't need to reserve a spot. You just come on in. We are open pretty much all the time, and you can watch what they're doing.
So they're only in session every other year? That's not the only time laws are passed?
That is correct. So they can have special session. When the governor calls those, it's 30 days each. Last year there were three, so they went all the way up to the end of October, which is pretty rare, but it can happen. In the off years, there are events going on here. It's not always government related, but usually in the off years, they are all back all over Texas with their constituents, and they have their jobs to support themselves.
Something crazy would happen, and we needed to
convene,
and they would call
a
special session, and we would be
there.
And we would be here still.
Do they get paid?
Very part-time, so okay. They get paid for a part-time
like
job.
How much? I don't even know. I'm curious.
I don't actually know the amount, but it's not a lot. So they, well, back in the early days, a lot of them were supporting themselves with a farm, so this made sense, because you can still drive for 12 hours in Texas and still be in Texas. So they needed some time to be tending to their livelihood. And they still do it that way. It's actually in the state constitution to do it that way. So if it ever were to change, you would definitely hear about it, whatever state you were in. Now, a few things to point out on this. Right up in the center there, underneath the green curtain, there's a portrait, kind of a smaller size, that is Stephen F. Austin, and it's one of the views he goes for the end of his life. And that was probably done as a gift for his sister's residence, so that's why it's a little bit smaller than some of the portraits.
They donned the Alamo and the Battle of San Jacinto over on the other side of the chamber. Now, it's something I'd recommend coming back to spend a little bit more time with. There's a lot of detail in both of these paintings. There's also always a guy at the desk here in the Senate who you can ask questions about the paintings. But a few things I'll point out. Up there, in the center of the painting, you'll see a red flag being thrown in the air. Well, that represents no quarter. Santa Anna had actually said that everyone fighting the Texas Revolution will be killed, either in combat or they will be executed. He is essentially saying, if you are participating in this, expect to die. And he thinks this is going to kind of discourage the Texans from participating in the revolution. All of the Alamo combatants are killed as a result, 189 of them. And instead of discouraging them, it kind of lights fire under the Texans for independence. So 6 weeks later, at the Battle of San Jacinto, you have an army of 900 Texans who are still outnumbered, but they're charging in, shouting, "Remember the Alamo," as battle cry, and it's been said in Texas a few times since. Now, they win their independence in only 18 minutes, and Texas becomes its own sovereign republic. Now, it's a pretty brief overview. Feel free to ask questions as we go, but we are gonna head over to the House chamber and take a look at a few things over there. Over this way. Once again, if you go out, mindful of those steps.
Cool. We went to Alamo and San Jacinto. So it's connected.
That's perfect. Awesome.
Yeah.
This is our third big lake in Texas.
Oh, that's wonderful. Yeah. We're doing it more around and learning a lot about Texas history. That's cool.
So fast. Good girl. Good job. Oh, good job. I love gift shop. I love gift shop. That's so fast, love. Oh, look, I like that one. It makes this more. Thank you. I just want a picture of this. You can see the dome over there.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Our city.
Okay.
You can go in and be on
the. Really cool. cool. We didn't ask about that.
Why are the cameras in there?
No, we didn't ask about that. Who is that holding the star over there next to the flag? Cherish Texas Rangers, Provisional Army of the Confederate States. Okay. Texas Ranger. That's the capital.
I don't know when they put these statues up, but now the tree line's kind of all grown up into the museum. Yeah.
Last order.
I don't think they're going to. Okay. That
was cool. So, just get out of the capital. And it was really cool. Very cool. So yeah, it's against the light. There you go. And there's something going on in there. Maybe it's part of their Texas Day on March 2nd.